Hey everybody, it's Star Wars Fan 71. And in the last part, we defeated Jon Bassam and did not claim the Clockwork Talons. All of our clockwork parts were stolen. Don't worry, I'll buy all this stuff just for the heck of it. What was that about? Some more cha-ching. Oh. Here we go. There we go. Okay, to say that was funny is an understatement. Where'd you go? There you are. Yep, none of these, remember guys, none of these are freebies. There's a ball. Come on, come on. I was stuck. Oh! If memory serves me correctly, there, buddy. Thank you. I know where one of them is. How to get it. Got me. Oh. Right up there. Like I said just a minute ago, how to get it? You got me. There it is. Like I said, I know where one of them is. How to get it? You got me. There we go. Section of his own triumph with talking stupid kid and I think we'll continue looking for these after this.
My instruments have picked up large magnetic fields radiating from inside that blimp. If arpeggios already started reassembling clockwork, that's where you'll find them.
Sounds good. I'm on my way.
Don't waste any time here, Sly. Get to the blimp and take some recon photos. To build a plan, we need to know how close.
got it under control.
At least Sly hasn't said that ever in this game. What the? Wait, is there a bottle on this blimp? Let's try and do a sequence break, actually. Playing this, I already got this picture. Enjoy one? Oh! I remember this part, guys. Can we get from here? That was a close one. Dodged him. don't see why. Your point exactly, Bentley? That was weird. You guys should have seen the analog button. Short and fast one, guys. That's one down, three to go. Okay, if it's got red on it, you've already reversed its polarity. Silly guys, but for a second I thought I was on the other side. And is clockwork destroyed?
What's all this then? The magnets have been reversed. But by Jove, it seems to have locked the clockwork parts into place. Excellent.
I'll be back in a sec, guys.
Mr. Cooper, no doubt you believe a reversal would pull the old bird apart, eh? But it seems to have quite the opposite effect. I'm truly grateful. When fully powered up, I'll join myself to its circuits and be all out of gold.
All this because you can't fly. You're pathetic.
Immortality. Immortality is what I seek. Other Claw Gang members were much too short-sighted. They were satisfied using the clockwork parts to drive their various trivial schemes. But not me. No, I saw them for what they really were. The keys to life eternal.
So, what? You had Neela put me on the send back in Cairo, and then waited while I stole the parts from the other Claw Gang members. All the while not arousing any suspicion that you were behind it all?
You make it sound easy, Cooper. I had to carry your pathetic gang through that first set of heists. I was overjoyed when Arpeggio let me toss you in jail. I could finally go after the parts myself.
Ah, but acquiring all the parts was only half the equation. Cooper, what kept Clockwork alive for thousands of years?
He was fueled by his hatred for my family.
Splendid! That's right. Hatred. Putting its gears and wires together was child's play compared with accumulating that much hatred.
You can't make people hate.
Oh, my poor naive boy. My meticulous mind is like the rain. As your proper compass friend can attest, spice consumption makes you both arrogant and susceptible to hypnosis. The Contessa, hypnotist extraordinaire, devised a way to command people through the use of flashing lights. I've created this blimp to be a massive transmitter of those precise light frequencies. The only problem I faced was finding a suitable source of light waves.
The Northern Lights. You've been collecting Northern Light energy so you could hypnotize everyone beneath the blimp.
Ah, hypnotize those who eat food covered in illegal spice. Thank goodness for Dimitri. Through his nightclub, he got the whole city to consume the spice.
You're going to Paris to unleash a hypnotic light show of hate. That's outlandishly cruel.
Cruel, perhaps, but necessary to give Clockwork his spark of immortality. Ah, well, my new body awaits me. Be a dear, Neela, and keep him covered. Ta-da!
Stupid Arpeggio. I double-crossed the Cooper gang, Interpol, and Carmelita. Who made you think I wouldn't do the same to you?
She's right.
This is preposterous. You're my protege. Not the next candidate for my immortality. I demand you exit the Clockwork frame or...
Thank you. all know, things are looking grim. Neela has joined herself to the clockwork frame that the Union has produced. Blockla. She's out and free to terrorize the world. This blimp is still in motion to Paris. I could only assume Arpeggio's autopilot will activate the hate hypnosis light show. If that happens, there will be no stopping Blockla. She'll be immortal. But we still have a chance. In her new form, she'll need to draw a lot of energy from this blimp's engines to stay strong. If we can disable the engines, that should be enough to weaken her to a state in which we can attack. Getting at these engines will require all three of us to work together in perfect harmony. We've pulled off some tough jobs in the past, but they were just a warm-up round for what we'll be going through tonight.
We'll be going through it in the next part. See you guys then.